Other than the T-Rex, the Velociraptor has been cemented in pop culture as one of the most menacing dinosaurs that has ever lived. One of the main antagonists in the movie Jurassic Park, the Velociraptor traveled in packs and were quick and deadly with their talons. RAZORTV finds out how the creature technology company has conveyed the sense of speed into the Walking with Dinosaurs arena spectacular show.
So the show also has smaller dinosaurs, and we achieve these by quite a different technique. Even though there are similarities in the way we build the skin and we had the same challenges with weight and various things like that, these are one-person operated creature. The person would strap their legs, their feet into here. These are actually shoes under there, and their legs run on the inside into the body, and the whole creature is strapped on their body.
Right there, buddy, no stutter movements, man. Give him a little snap, mate.
Raptor feet, these are some of the parts that go into making raptors. So we cast these, and this is a backpack that that the performer straps into. So the performer in these raptor suits has one of these inside each suit.
They strap themselves in.
Support their weight.
And it supports their weight, and the straps that come over here. We take as much as possible, we take all the weight in the hips. So, and they've improved over time, so now these are all carbon fibre, they're very lightweight and they're very ergonomic. This is what lives inside a raptor. So you can imagine I'm the raptor performer, I'm in it like this, holding the rods so the head's out there, the tail's out that way. And this structure here is what the whole body's hung on.
So one performer, even though
they're holding the whole creature, they're not actually holding the whole creature, their hands are free to control the neck and various things like that. This is all TIG welded aluminium, and all, again, we use a lot of bungees to counterbalance these.
So the harness is just strapped in right here.
So the harness you saw earlier?
Yep.
Strapped in there. So the way that works is the puppeteer comes in here, sits in that seat, waits to let the raptor go on. When they're about to go on, he stands up, just wheels out the way, and it's just him and the puppet. So you don't see any of this structure here at all. And their vision hole is about here. It works well with what the creature should look like. It kind of makes sense, but you find in the show that they're doing a, this is the head, they're doing a lot of this, sort of lining it up, and then they have to go forward and do the business they have to do.
Nothing like the dinner table at your house, I'm sure. Up for you.
And so they control through rods coming up into the neck, the whole creature. So it can turn around and open its jaw and all that sort of stuff. It even has eye blinks.
Everything is all controlled inside?
All controlled by one person, so there's no remote control at all. And these are great in the show because they're really flexible, they can run around quite fast. And
they're pretty light, right?
And yeah, pretty light. We've got them much lighter. The ones from the original show were about 42 kilos. This one's down to about 30.
Oh, wow.
So we break less performance that way. It doesn't matter how good a puppeteer you are, unless you can run up and down an arena and still not totally collapse, it's a waste of time. So we're able to teach a lot of these guys the skills of puppetry, but as long as they had a foundation of fitness, we could at least get that far.
I could actually open it up for you, I think.
So this is an example of, I guess, of the skin technique and how we combine it with muscle bags. So underneath this skin, there's these what we call muscle bags, and they're stretch netting bags with polystyrene beads inside them. And they are anatomically very similar to the muscles that would be on this creature. So as the creature's leg moves forward and back, they stretch and they contract so that so it's actually changing the shape of the limb. So this is a sort of muscle bag structure that we have underneath our creatures. So you can see here,
what I mean. So this whole joint here is flexing,
and then as it moves through here, this is stretching, contracting. So that's how we get that sort of realistic movement transferring through to the skin.
With all this attention to detail and realism, isn't it a waste that the film industry has moved towards computer-generated imagery over animatronics? Next up, Sunny tells us how relevant the craft is in today's film industry.